When we got to the mainland, we found the space elevator's support facility. I guess this was the factory where they built the gigantic structure the elevator traveled in. There was this little girl sitting in front of a mural. When the princess saw her, she shuddered like she'd seen a ghost. The girl had a stuffed animal. This was the day after the shit went down at Tyler Island. She walked right up to the princess, took her hand, and led her into the factory. One thing's for sure, they knew each other. The factory'd been converted to a production line for Erusian drones. It was fully automated and chugging along, making drone after drone after drone. Once they got inside, the princess stopped and just stood there. Another girl was there with a man in a lab coat. He was trying to use his keyboard, but she wouldn't let him. She took a data chip and threw it on the ground. Then she walked over to us and took the gun from the prison guard's holster. She pulled the trigger and destroyed the chip. Later, I found out that the girl with the gun and the one with the stuffed animal were sisters. They were also the granddaughters of Mihai A. Shilaji, the legendary pilot. Gramps used to talk about him. He said Mihai was the top ace from two wars ago. Know any Belkans? Because this guy was a Belkan, and they love to stir shit up. Pitting nations against other nations is a particular favorite of theirs, along with developing hyper-advanced technology.
That's right. I'm Belkan, born and raised. My country is gone now. Rather than surrender to its enemy, Belka detonated 7 nuclear weapons on its own soil. My people scattered around the globe, living in the shadows of other countries. We had a new purpose: to breed wars. The theory was that through war, we could achieve our destiny and our revenge. I had just finished inputting Mihai's data when his granddaughter came in. She destroyed the only copy I had of the information I squeezed out of him. The girl loved Mihai. No one knew more than her just how hard I pushed her grandfather for that data, how much I made him sacrifice in the process. I promised his granddaughters that his efforts were not in vain, that it could end this terrible war. But in the end, it only caused more chaos and despair. We were responsible for all this damage, all this tragedy. Now, we were going to pay for it. The Erusians, once our allies, would see to that. I had lost the drive to continue my work, even before I noticed Mihai's granddaughters eyeing me with suspicion that one day. I should have stopped then, for all our sakes. Mihai's granddaughter tossed the gun aside. She said if she resorted to killing, she'd just end up like the rest of us. And by us, she meant everyone, including the princess. Like me, the princess was afraid to look into the girl's eyes. She knew that by encouraging her people, she kept the war going. Mihai and his granddaughter were victims of it, and now, they too were paying the price.
Is this for Belka? Or for Erusia? My grandfather had only one wish: to continue soaring through the endless skies. That was the only place where he felt alive. But I don't even have a country to call home, let alone the sky. The Black Forest, the lake, they are no longer mine. Even though those lands were once cherished by my late mother. We have to learn to put that sense of nostalgia behind us and behave like mature adults.
My homeland. She's right. It feels so far away now. The woman with the rifle approached me. She was focused on more pressing issues.
I checked the computer. All of the data on the legendary ace had already been installed.
No, I pulled it before it was completed. However, there are two aircraft that are already scheduled to be manufactured based on that data.
We must destroy the factory.
This isn't the only one. There are more facilities just like it, and the two planes containing the data will be manufactured at one of those facilities.
So, this place runs on solar power that the space elevator generates, right? How about the others? We can destroy the space elevator and cut the power to them. First things first, let's take this one out.
I'll show you which locations to target.
I stood there, thinking about that mural by the factory's entrance. Harling commissioned it to be painted. I realized that in the background, behind the dancing figures, the artist had painted several space elevators. I understand now. The space elevator wasn't designed to exploit Erugia after all.
Good. And afterwards, we'll bring down the space elevator itself. No matter why it was built, right now, it's the root of this chaos.
I wonder.
Yes?
I wonder which path you would choose when looking at Harling's mirror.
Let's get the briefing started.
We've done enough air operations. Just let us go home.
There's no path for us to get home. Whatever direction you fly, it'll be right into a hail of enemy fire. Earlier, we received a communication via the partially restored general network. Here is what it contained. Apparently, the Erugian radicals have gathered around the space elevator, as it's a source of energy. Give the war mongrels a powerful energy source, and you give them the luxury to keep on fighting. In response to this, people from both Osea and Erugia have joined forces and will take down the final arsenal bird in a saturation attack from the air. Once that's achieved, they'll take the space elevator from the aggressors.
Has the source been verified?
It could be fake. I hear you. Take a look at what's written at the end. Hey, dumbass. If you want to bring the world back from the brink, go to the light and see the future.
Dumbass? Sounds familiar.
It certainly does. It's from those guys we met in Tyler Island, the 444 squad. It's a message to all those looking to end the war. But I also think it's a message for Trigger.
I guess we'll do what it says.
Okay. Well, then I'm thinking we go roast that damn bird.
Looks like we're all on the same page. It's time to end this war. Time to fly, guys. Let's go get that arsenal bird.
Let's get the briefing started.
We've done enough air operations. Just let us go home.
There's no path for us to get home. Whatever direction you fly, it'll be right into a hail of enemy fire. Earlier, we received a communication via the partially restored general.
Thank you.
Strider Squadron, sortie ASAP.
Focus on the Attack everything you've got.
Open fire.
Missile.
Attack failed! Cruise missiles did not reach their target!
Damn monster!
Broadcaster warning all aircraft. I have multiple blips on my scope.
Here they come.
That's something.
Hey, look at the Arsla bird.
Lasers!
HQ, we have a problem. The damage to the Allied fleet is extensive.
Mickle.
That was a pretty impressive firepower. I, for one, did not see that coming.
Mickle. The active protection system operated as expected. Mickle. We should launch another saturation attack. Air power. Also the Arsenal bird.
Strider 1 was shut down.
Smash it! Special six of them faster! It'll lose power!
propeller. You're getting the hang of this trigger.
Destroyed.
Destroyed. That's two of them.
Don't let yourself be distracted. Just focus on what you need to do. Catch a bell.
Freak you out. Trigger, let's do this.
What?
Is he really that good of a...
module destroyed. That's two of them.
Don't let yourself be distracted. Just focus on what you need to do.
The Pekin tabloid went after a safe. He ran that distance with a girl in his hands.
God, what about tabloid? Is he safe?
George and the girl were saved. They were saved. Both of them.
Docking module destroyed. One left.
Nicely done. This'll be a good story to tell my son. Lock.
Watch it. Enemy has a lock on you. Strata 1, target acquired. All targets have been destroyed. Supply units ready to fall off.
Yes! Good job.
You should be able to see the wreck tenant where the supply unit was. Destroy that, and even the mighty Ars Laverne is sure to feel it.
Has a lock.
Good luck.
Leave it to Trigger.
Don't let us down, Strider 1. Clear a path for Strider 1.
Leave the big fish to Trigger. We'll take down the UAVs.
We're counting on you.
Lieutenant, base unit confirmed destroyed.
Broadcaster.
Trigger, break off. Arsenal Bird is losing altitude rapidly.
Arsenal Bird is down.
Longcaster, can you estimate the point of impact?
Don't worry, looks like it'll be open water. All aircraft, avoid the target's path.
That's the last of the rogues. Even in death, that thing is intimidating. Nice work. You pulled off a perfect landing. Well, we're okay for the moment. Now the real challenge begins.
Well, if it isn't the LRSSG, looks like our luck has turned.